Despite the rather sombre entry, today is a feast day. We're celebrating the baptism of Christ. And unfortunately, our organist Chris Simmons has broken down at Brian McGowan Bridge, West Gosford. So he's over there cooling his heels and waiting for the RMA to arrive so that he can hopefully get going again. Apparently it's a problem with his clutch. And also our head server, he's unable to be here today, so that was why there was a lot of running around and getting everything ready, because we were running a little bit late because of that. But welcome to all of you who've come to share in what is, in effect, the final Feast Sunday of the Christmas season, the baptism of our Lord. And as we continue to see Christ manifest in his Epiphany, and particularly today, the voice that came from heaven acknowledging him as the Son of God. God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. And he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts strain, all desires turn, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, the Son of God, has been revealed as a light to the nations. Let us bring our darkness to his light, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us with love and obey you in this life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The prayer of the day. Loving God, your Son came to seek the lost and was baptized with sinners. Grant that we who have been baptized in his name may reach out in love to those in need with the mercy of Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen. Would you please be seated?
First reading is a reading from Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. and God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm today is our psalm to the God. Ascribe to the Lord, ye powers of heaven, ascribe to the Lord glory and might.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due to his name, and worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness.
The voice of the Lord is upon the waters, the God of glory thunders, the Lord upon the great waters.
The voice of the Lord is mighty in operation, the voice of the Lord is a glorious voice.
The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees, the Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon.
He makes them stiff like a young cup, Lebanon and Syria like a young wild ox.
The voice of the Lord divides the lightning flash, the voice of the Lord whirls the sand of the desert, the Lord whirls the desert of Kadesh.
The voice of the Lord rends the terrible trees and strips bare the forests. In his name all cry and glory.
The Lord sits enthroned above the water flow. The Lord sits enthroned as a king forever.
The Lord will give strength to his people. The Lord will give to his people a blessing and peace.
Second reading is a reading from Acts, chapter 19, verses 1 to 7. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the inland regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." And then he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" And they answered, "Into John's baptism," Paul said. "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 of them. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I'm not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the River Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart, and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." For the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Please be seated. This being only the second Sunday of the new year, there's still a sense of freshness and new beginnings. Many of us are still trying to get used to writing or typing 2021 instead of 2020. I must say that I've not made that mistake so far in typing or writing. Must be because we're so anxious to get away from 2020 with the year that it's been. Our readings today are also about new beginnings. They ground us in the reality of God, who is the source and the beginning of all things. Our reading from Genesis, the first book of the Bible, the first chapter, and the first verse, right back to the beginning. The creation of the world, the beginning of all things. God bringing order out of chaos and life out of nothingness. And then our reading from the book of Acts. Acts is the book of the church's beginnings, an account of the baptism of Gentiles, those who were not part of the household of faith, the Jewish nation, baptized, Gentiles, and others, and before them Samaritans, were received into the church, not just one particular ethnicity or people group. And the receiving of the Holy Spirit to these Gentiles, baptism marks for us the beginning of new life in Christ. And then from the Gospel of Mark, the baptism of Jesus, right at the very beginning of his public ministry. It's all about fresh starts, beginnings. Our first reading tells us the creation had its origin in water. The Spirit of God brooded or hovered over the primeval void and darkness. When we are born, we are encased in a sack of water, and we're born out of that. Water sustains and nourishes all living things, plant and animal. The new life we receive from Christ also begins in water, the waters of baptism. In the beginning, the Spirit of God hovered over the waters, bringing forth life. In baptism, the Spirit of God hovers over humanity and brings forth the church. Baptism reminds us what being the church is all about. This is why we renew our baptismal promises at Easter. This is one of the reasons we make the sign of the cross, to ground us again in our baptism and the name of the Trinity. This is a reason why it is so important to witness baptism, to at least remind us of what it means to be a part of this community we call church. When the church forgets that, then it gets caught up in a whole lot of things that detract from its main business. It's interesting, every parish I've been to, that many of the activities that parish churches are involved in normally have little to do with its main purpose. Jesus gave his disciples a mandate. We call it the Great Commission, to go and to baptize and make other disciples and teach them what he had taught them, the teachings he had taught them. Jesus did not give any instructions on how to make lamentons. Jesus did not explain how to man a cake stall or to engage in fundraising, or to elect officers and conduct the meeting properly. Not that these things don't have a place, but they are not our main business. And yet for many, that's the extent of their church involvement. When Jesus called a group of disciples, he was forming them into a community. Church is a way of us being together. We are a family. Now that doesn't mean
being and thinking alike on everything. It's just like our earthly families. We don't always get along. Some of the other members irritate us. Even in the New Testament, the life of some churches was a downright scandal. But just as we belong to our families in spirit, and in spite of our differences and our diversity, so baptism reminds us that we belong to each other. The Christian faith is not some private affair that we keep to ourselves. It's not simply a matter of my personal relationship with God without any reference to my fellow believers in Christ. St. Paul reminded the bickering members of the church at Corinth, "For in one spirit you were all baptized into one body." This is why the division of the church into so many different denominations and groups is such a scandal. Baptism also reminds us that the initiative lies with God, not with us. We are saved by God, not by our own efforts. The church is a gift. It is not something we achieve. The church is not something that we make happen. It's not what we make out of it. It is what God makes out of us. Many people, and I'm one of them, I'm not pointing the finger at anybody, but when you arrive here on a Sunday morning, we immediately swing into action. Now, to be sure, there are lots of things to be done. There are bulletins to be handed out, there's PowerPoints, there's organs, there's mics, there's lights, and morning teas when we have them. And each week, there are faithful people who do these jobs, and we're very grateful to them. But a danger is that these things become ends in themselves, and people see only their part to play, forgetting that the whole is important, and forgetting that the focus of all of it is God. And the net result can be one of stress and frenetic activity and distraction instead of prayerful waiting upon God. Baptism reminds us it is about God. God joins us to God's family, the church. You can't join a family like you join a club. You have to be born into it. And if you're not born into it, the only way you can become part of it is by being adopted into it. We don't join the church so much as we are joined to it. Even as early as the time of the New Testament, Christians spoke of their salvation in terms of adoption. In his letter to the Romans, Paul says, "For you did not receive a spirit of fear that makes you a slave again. No, but you received a spirit of adoption. And by him we cry, Abba, Father." So, the newly baptized become the responsibility of the church to care for them. That means never giving up, just like the shepherd in Jesus' parable when he went out in search of a lost sheep, one lost sheep, even though he had 99. Like the father waiting at home who never gives up for the waiting son, waiting for his son to return home. That's how God treats us when we wander off, when we disobey, when we fail to be faithful. God comes looking for us, and God brought us home. It's unconditional, unremitting, unrelenting, persevering love. Finally, baptism reminds us that our faith is more than a matter of words and propositions and statements. Baptism takes faith beyond the merely verbal, beyond the merely verbal and the intellectual, beyond the realm of words and thoughts into the world of reality, of action, of doing. In baptism, something happens to you. You get wet. The Christian life is just that. It's something to be immersed in, a way of life, not just mentally assenting to certain articles of faith. At the end of the Eucharist, we pray, "Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. We go forth from here to serve God with our whole being." When Jesus was baptized, a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, the Beloved, in whom I am well pleased." In this age when so many people are searching for identity, where so many feel disoriented and dislocated, let us today go back to our roots, to our beginnings, and be reminded of who we are by God's grace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Let us together affirm the faith of the Church.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for God's world and for God's church.
Everlasting God, we give thanks for this new day, and as we gather here to focus on the baptism of our Lord, we remember our own baptism and our calling to be Christians. Fill us with such joy that our hearts overflow with love for you and for all who we meet along our journey. And help us to understand the mystery of the baptism of your Son. May we walk in your way, live our life for you, and be mindful of your presence day by day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Creator God, we remember all countries where there is war, conflict, or divisive elements among the people, and pray that you will look mercifully upon the sufferings of the people involved. We pray for our Prime Minister and his government, the state premiers and their governments, and the leaders in the rest of the world. Sharpen their consciences and give them the courage to make wise decisions, making wrong right, and meeting the needs of all who suffer, especially as the pandemic continues worldwide. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Father God, we pray today for our friends, our families, and our Christian community, that united by our common baptism, we may always welcome the newcomer, the stranger, and all who are vulnerable. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we pray for those who face difficulties in their personal lives. We hold before you all who are sick, the bereaved, those with problems in their families, in their relationships, in their neighbourhoods, or in their workplace. Give them a patient faith in their troubles and the knowledge that you share their sufferings with them. Give peace and healing to those on our parish list of the sick and others known to us. Lord, in your mercy. Mighty God, Lord of unending being, we pray for those whose earthly lives have ended. We remember those whose anniversary of their death falls at this time, and for the souls of all who have died recently. We give thanks for their lives well lived and for happy memories. May they rest in the eternal joy of heaven, and let all who mourn their dark death find comfort and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Faithful God, we thank you for making us your children, for feeding us with the spiritual food which satisfies our longings, and for the promise that you listen to our supplications and answer our requests. Lord, in your mercy. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour be yours, always and everywhere. Mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. You anointed him as Messiah, the light of the nations, and revealed him as the hope of all who thirst for justice and peace. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. And we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance. After supper he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink, in remembrance. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ has risen.
Christ
will come again. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise.
Blessing, honor, and glory, and power, I yours forever and ever.
Let us pray for the unity of all peoples on earth in the words our Saviour has taught us.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As this broken bread was once many grains which had been gathered together and made one bread, So may your church be gathered from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. God of the nations, we thank you for nourishing us with this holy sacrament. Guide us by your presence, that we may bring your light to those who dwell in darkness and establish your justice in the earth. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice through Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. May Christ the Son of God be manifest to you, that your lives may be a light to the world, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love.